This video shows how to use the warehouse management template that was released in Microsoft Dynamics 365 for finance and operations. We'll see how to copy the configuration of a warehouse from one company to a new company within the same instance. To make it easy to determine which data to copy, we'll use the default configuration templates, which can be found in the Data Management workspace. We'll use the Inventory template and the Warehouse Management template. To create a new data project, select the Copy into Legal Entity tile. Here, you can define how to copy data to a new company. We'll use the USP2 company as the source of the configuration data. So, in the Source Legal Entity field, enter the source company USP2. In the Group Name field, enter a new company, for example, GBP2. This is the new company you're copying data to. We'll reuse the number sequences that are defined in the USP2 company, but we'll reset them to the smallest values. Next, click Create Legal Entities to create the new legal entity. After we have created the new legal entity, we can easily add data from templates. First, we'll add the inventory template and then the warehouse management template to this project. Next, we'll add data entities by using the default configuration templates. Now it's easy to maintain the project. In this video, we aren't going to include any of the ledger definitions from the inventory templates, so we'll remove them by searching for the data entities that begin with ledger and then deleting them. Next, we'll add two additional data entries to the project. The first data entity is disposition code, which is needed when using the sales order return disposition codes. The second data entity is document types, which are needed when defining the warehouse management parameters. Now let's select Copy into Legal Entity. This process will take some time because it copies all data from the data entities in the USP2 company to the new GBP2 company. Now you can see that there are three records that haven't been copied to the new company. Let's figure out why they weren't copied. Use Filter by Errors to search for the data that failed to copy. Select Fixed Product Locations as an example. Select View Staging Data. Here you can see that one record did not get copied. As the error message states, an item number is needed to copy a fixed production location record. We didn't include any master or reference data for the projects, so we can't copy it to the new company. Instead of copying data between companies within the same instance, like we've shown in this video, you can export the data and save it in a different file format, for example, Excel, using Export Project. Thanks for watching.